So you've just downloaded The Sims 2, but you can't even play it because of shit like this. And other shit like this. Well, fear no more, because I'm gonna fix it. Hopefully. I mean, it might not work, but it should work because I've done this for a bit. Get this stupid fucking jacket off me. No, but seriously, I've managed to get rid of all the crashing, all the graphical bugs with what I'm gonna show you today. So let's crack on with it. G'day everyone, how are we all doing? So you've just got The Sims 2, whether legally or illegally. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is go down into the description and click on the graphics rule maker link that I've left down in there. Open that up and click on download graphics rules maker in step one. It's gonna take you to the setup wizard. All you gotta do is click next a couple of times and choose an install location. You can just leave this as default, it doesn't really matter, but I'm gonna put mine on my D drive. Next up, you can choose to have it create a shortcut. I don't want that, you might. It's up to you, but personally, I'm not gonna have it. Then it's down to which components you want to install. If you only care about The Sims 2, then only select The Sims 2. If you want to build your own neighborhoods in The Sims 2, then you want The Sims 2 and SimCity 4. But you'll also need to download SimCity 4 to get that. For this tutorial, I'm just going to have only Sims 2 selected because that's all we need. Hit install and it'll download. Click run graphics rules maker and click finish. This last part is the hardest part, but it's not that hard if you follow along. Hey, you following along? Keep up. Next, you're going to want to locate where you've installed your game. Click on browse and go to where you have your game stored. Then just click on locate game and you should get game found video cards database loaded. Make sure that in the game section you have The Sims 2 selected and not The Sims 2 body shop. Next up, game tweaks. Change force texture memory to 4096. This next part is going to be highly dependent on what graphics card you have. First up, tick these two boxes at the top. If you have AMD Radeon HD 7000 series, make sure you click on the fix AMD Radeon blah blah blah. That's going to make sure that it doesn't force you to load graphics. I have an Nvidia card, so I'm not going to click it. If you are running integrated graphics on an Intel CPU, click on these two at the bottom here. That is only if you don't have a graphics card. Lastly, change your default and maximum resolutions to the resolution of your monitor. Once that's all done, you can hit save files, and it should give you a prompt of what graphics card you have. Click yes, and then click OK. And that's the first part done. The reason we had to do this is because The Sims 2 was made in 2004, and at the time, they didn't know that you, Chelsea, or Hannah, we're gonna have a 4090 in your computer. Now that that's all done and dusted, we can move on to the second thing. And this is the 4GB patch, which I will leave down in the description as well. All of these links that I'm telling you to go through to download things can be found in the description. So what the 4GB patch is gonna do is bring the game from using 2GB of RAM to 4. That's why before, with the graphics rule maker, we set the memory to 4096MB. So we're just gonna download this right here. We're gonna double click on the executable file, and it's gonna tell us to select an executable in here. Now, we're not selecting a place to download it, we're selecting The Sims 2 game. So you need to go to where The Sims 2 is downloaded. Here it is, The Sims 2 Ultimate Collection. You want to go to the latest expansion pack that you own. If you have all of them, the latest one is Mansion and Garden Stuff. Go into the TS Bin folder, and this one right here where it says Sims 2 EP9, click on that, and click on Open. You should get a little thing saying executable successfully patched. Now you can just hit OK, and that's completely done. It's now time to hear a word from our sponsor. Me!
Huh?
Cuz who would want to sponsor a channel with 380 subs? I sure wouldn't. Would you? You probably couldn't. You're not a business, are you? Well, hey, you know, it would help out greatly if you would like the video. Yeah, you. I'm talking about you. Like the video, please. It helps out so much. No, but seriously, it would mean the world to me. Thank you all for watching. And hey, let's get back to the content you all came here for. All right, and this is the last thing I need to show you today. You wanna click on the last link in the description, this will take you to GitHub, where we're gonna be downloading version 2.2, or whatever the latest one is for you, of DXVK. So we're gonna come right down to the bottom of the page here and click on dxvk-2.2.tar.gz. Once that's downloaded, we can open it, and you'll see this folder, dxvk-2.2. Double click on that. Now, because we're doing this on Windows 10, it's an x64-based system, so we're gonna click on x64, and you'll see 4 application extensions. We only need one of them, which is the first one, d3d9.dll. You're just going to click and drag this onto your desktop for now, and we're going to leave it. We can now close this. This next part you got to follow carefully, so fucking keep up, Chelsea, Hannah, both of you two, I'm looking at you. All right, so we're going to open Notepad. Now in here, we're going to type exactly this, d3d9.maxavailablememory equals 4096. Exactly how I have typed it here. But that's not all, because right now it's just a notepad. It doesn't mean anything. So we are going to go to File, Save As, You're gonna select your desktop. Now, first thing you wanna do is down here where it says save as type, changes from text documents to all files. And we're going to name this file a very specific thing. dxvk.conf, short for config. What this file is doing, it is telling d3d9.dll that we downloaded before that the max available memory that it has is 4 GB. We're going to leave encoding as UTF-8 and we're going to save it on the desktop. Now we can close Notepad and we should have our two files here. Next thing we're gonna do is right click on The Sims 2, open file location, and you should be back in the TS bin folder of The Sims 2 latest pack. Drag and drop both dxvk.config and d3d9.dll into that folder. Now that we've done this, we can close this folder and you are now ready to open the game. Well, there you go. No more pink flashing, no more purple flashing. Now, if at this point you are still getting the flashing, what you can try is raising the texture memory that we've set from 4096 to double that. Anyways, I hope this helped any of you out, as I struggled with this for a long time until I had to scour the internet looking for it. So I just wanted to put it all in one place for you guys. So now you guys, Hannah, Rebecca, Chelsea, you can all play The Sims 2 happily now. And hey, if you got to this point, that means you got something out of this video. So why don't you listen to what the sponsor guy said before and like the video? It helps out a heap as I'm a small channel, and simply just liking the video or leaving a comment can help to YouTube to push my video out to more people so I can help more people who are trying to run The Sims 2. If after this point you are still experiencing difficulties, leave a comment down below. I will try my best to help out. But that's it for this video, everyone. Take care.